Last week, we presented announcement that we're working with Xander to enable 605 advanced audiences in their platform. It is the first step of our 605 exchange, which is the umbrella brand for our currency services. And we're enabling folks to plan and post and create better media plans based on the 605 data sets.
And could you tell us a bit more about that 605 data set?
Oh, sure. That is our currency. We have national television measurement that covers over 200 networks and all different looks at advanced audiences. So looking at 120 million TV households, what is their composition? What do they watch? What time of day do they watch? And how do they respond to advertising?
So for marketers who may not know all the nitty-gritty about media buying and planning, what does it mean as far as their ability to target audiences and manage campaigns?
So, I think let's back up a little bit and talk about advanced audiences and how that is a little bit different from what they've done before and where it's going in the future. So the planning of advertising traditionally has been focused around some very, very broad definitions, and people in the industry will be familiar with the age, gender, day parts on networks. They'll talk about reaching adults 18 to 49 or 25 to 54, and what those are as a proxy for the real audience that advertisers want to hit. So for example, let's just say you're a family restaurant and you want to bring in larger families to your restaurant. And traditionally you would say, oh, let me use a adults 25 to 54 target. What we're doing today with advanced audiences is we're enabling clients to plan against more specific, more relevant and precise target definitions that are based on first and third party data sets. And I'll bring that example forward a little bit. So if you wanted to reach larger families for this family restaurant, you would look into Experian, a partner of ours, and say, okay, I'm going to pick households that are 4+ in the number of people in the household. And I want to actually, from our Place IQ data, pick households who actually have been to a family style restaurant in the last 3 months. So that kind of precise audience targeting is what we mean by advanced audiences, and that enables people to have more efficient and more effective advertising plans that actually bring more people to the restaurants.
And with these audiences, they're for linear television, correct?
Well, it's a good question. It's actually for wherever television or digital video is viewed. We are focusing on this first one, which what's called data-driven linear with these audiences. But later this year, we'll be adding in the digital audiences. So you can take a look at how different audiences respond from different platforms. So will you have a better response from a target if you presented in a CTV environment or a straight up television environment? So we are going to be increasing our services to include those, but today it's primarily a data-driven linear with Xander, and that is on over 130 networks.
That's interesting. Mm-hmm. Now, looking at it from the perspective of viewers, what do you think this means as far as either seeing more relevant ads or advertising that may feel less intrusive? What are your thoughts there?
100%. This advanced audiences and targeting helps everybody in the industry. It helps the advertiser convert more sales, talk to the right people. It allows buyers to sell their inventory with more meaningful relevance for the buyer, but it also helps the consumer experience because they get the right messaging or messaging that is relevant to them. You don't have ads over and over and over with high frequency that have no meaning to you. When you can use advanced audiences to target meaningful messages to households or persons, you can improve the experience and reduce the amount of frequency that's needed to get the same kind of sales lift. So it is a win-win-win situation for consumers, advertisers, and sellers.
And recently, we've been hearing a lot more about this idea of persuadable audiences and consumers. What can you tell us about those?
Though persuadable audiences are one of the most exciting parts of what we call our advanced audiences. It is a very specific technique that we use machine learning plus some guide, some supervision, and we are working with clients year over year over year to perfect their targets for persuadable audiences. And what this is reducing and focusing a target audience for households that are more responsive to advertising. We take out the types of audiences that would never respond or who always respond and always purchase regardless of the ad. So we focus the money just where the ad has the most effect or the most lift. And what we're enabling clients to do is improve their lift, their outcomes, by between 2 and 10 times the ability that from just regular targeting. So with our stewardship, our clients are working in an iterative process to get more persuadable audiences. Very, very exciting. And that's what most of our clients are bringing to the upfront.
Now, finally, just looking ahead, what do you expect to happen in the, say, next 6 months to a year? And I don't know, we have the upfronts coming up. Just please tell us, you know, what's on your schedule ahead.
Well, yeah, thank you. We are steeped in the upfronts right now. Our partners are bringing information that they glean from our 605 impact product. So we have a very hefty attribution product, and we've been working with clients for years on perfecting their advanced audiences by using the attribution to inform those audiences. So we have several clients, both programmer side, advertiser side, and agency side, that are bringing these audiences to the upfront and planning better campaigns and buys. So that's happening right now, and that's very exciting. Later on this year, speaking for 605 platform, we're integrating more digital impressions into both the planning aspects, the media measurement, and the attribution methods. And so we're able to really connect all the dots from planning, posting, buying, and evaluating all on the same currency grade data set. And then continuing on this year under the 605 Exchange brand, we are adding more data partners. So increasing, but today we have Experian, Polk, Catalina, PlaceIQ. We're going to be adding a couple of more data partners to improve the advanced audiences. But what I think we're going to see for the rest of this year is the implementation of these advanced audiences, and people will be planning and analyzing the effects of these better currencies for television and digital. And I think there's going to be a growing excitement and more experimentation, not less, across the whole industry.